The Impressionism period began after Romantic period artists felt it was too restrictive and not introspective enough. They didn't want to be pinned by conventional musical ideas of the past. Instead, they wanted to create moods and suggestions of images from their works. Though the Impressionism period was short, only about 20 years, it provided a necessary link between the Romantic period of the 19th century and the contemporary period of the 20th century. The Baroque, Classical, and Romantic periods were dominated by German, Austrian, and Italian composers. The Impressionists were led by the French. Although they hated being labeled Impressionists, Claude Debussy and Maurice Ravel were at the head of this new movement. Maurice Ravel was born in 1875 and received his musical training at the Paris Conservatory of Music. He wrote fewer works than most of his contemporaries and was treated rather harshly by music critics of the time. Ravel passed away in 1937 and was always hidden by the shadow of his fellow Impressionist composer, Debussy. Ravel was one of the first composers and musicians to recognize the importance of the newly invented technology of recording. Claude Debussy is the main French composer of the Impressionist period. He spent 11 years studying at the Paris Conservatory of Music. Debussy's signature work is a 10-minute long symphonic poem called Prélude à l'après-midi du faun, or Prelude to the Afternoon of a Faun. Debussy's music is characterized by long, flowing phrases, thick, sonorous harmonies, and parallel tonality. His goal was to create the suggestion of a mood or atmosphere. He wrote orchestral music, but was heavily favored toward the piano. Debussy led a tempestuous life. His only child, a daughter named Emma, died at the age of 13. Debussy passed in 1918, and his funeral had to be postponed due to an artillery attack by the Germans on the city during World War I.
Thank you.
The Impressionism period didn't last very long. Very quickly, German, Russian, and up-and-coming American composers were scaling the walls of creativity and expression in the new 20th century. Impressionism provided a bridge between Romantic and contemporary classical music. It opened up new harmonies and interpretations of tonality that would be even more expounded upon in the contemporary period.